Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Welcome to Bologna, welcome to the 8th International Symposium on Temporal Design. First of all, let me thank Professor Yoichi Ando, who established this series of symposia in the past and who today is here with us. Thank you, Professor Ando. Secondly, I am very happy that the symposium this year is held in Italy, and particularly in Bologna, my city. I hope that this will be a wonderful opportunity for people coming from other parts of the world to know Bologna, which has a fully preserved historical center and many things to discover, not only works of art, but also shops, restaurants. Bologna is one of the Italian capitals of food. By the way, you find in the bag an invitation for a wine tasting this afternoon. It's free, don't miss it. And let me remember that this symposium has been jointly organized by the Acoustic Research Group of the University of Bologna and by the Italian Acoustical Association. So now I leave the floor to the president of the Italian Acoustical Association, Professor Luigi Maffei. But first, let me thank you all for being here. Enjoy the symposium.
Thank you, Massimo. I just a few words to introduce this conference, this symposium, and to introduce also the Acoustical Society of Italy, which I represent in this moment. As you probably know, because many of you are also members of our Acoustical Society of Italy, AIA represents, let me say, acoustics in Italy, in effect, not just because of the number of members who join our association, but because of the activities we have every year on this topic. We founded in 1972, but let me say that in the last 15 years we had several international conferences. We are founders of ICA, we are founders of EAA, European Acoustic Association, the International Institute of Noise Control, and IAV. So we, in the last 15 years, we organized ICA in Rome, Euronoise in Naples, ISAV in Florence, SB conference. But in parallel, we also organized several small symposiums on very important topics of research, new topics of research. This is one of the examples. And we found that this kind of activities is very important also for young generation and young people, researchers that want to get attracted by this very wide topic, which is acoustics. So thank you to be here and in this very wonderful place. Enjoy the city, enjoy the conference, and thank you again.
Now I have to address a very deep thank to Teatro Comunale di Bologna, who hosted this symposium in this ancient and magnificent place. And now, on behalf of the Teatro, Maestro Nicola Sani will address you a few words. Please, Maestro.
Well, thank you, Professor Garai, thank you, Professor Maffei, and my warm welcome to all of you, ladies and gentlemen, to this symposium on acoustic and the temporal symposium on temporal design of the Associazione Italiana di Acustica. I'm particularly pleased to introduce this meeting because my presence here is, of course, officially as a general manager or intendant, as you prefer, of the house, but also because I am deeply connected to your research as a composer, And also as an experimental composer. So the relationship with the Associazione Italiana di Acustica, AIA, reminds me to my early stage and, of work in the experimental music and in connection with sound processing and digital synthesis and digital signal processing. I had, at that time, we are talking about the 80s, the old 80s, I had the pleasure to be part of the team of musical informatics at the in Rome at the Institute of Acoustics Orso Maria Corbino, which was a pioneer in the study of and research in digital sound processing. I remember we had a PDP 11 in one room, which is power is now replaced by an iPhone. So and also as a composer, I'm really interested in interaction between man and and machines and digital and digital interactive system. In my last opera I used sensors which were part of a system called motion capture which were connected to the action of the performer in order to determine the spectrum morphology of the sound in real time. So I mean there are really many possibility to of interaction between music and acoustic and new system and design and more a new system for the temporal design, and I am happy to say to you that you are always we will be always warmly welcome in this house. This is your sound house, as Bacon named this kind of places, and I hope that our cooperation can go further very strong and with future great results. Thank you very much, and have you all a good time in Bologna, and I wish you a fantastic symposium. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your kind words. And now we are going to open the symposium with the opening talk by Professor Emeritus Yoichi Ando, which will speak about maximizing preference and minimizing stress of life. Please, Professor Ando.
Thank you. Because I feel very familiar in this country, Italy and Bologna and Ferrara and so forth. And today's topic is that they are maximizing preference and minimizing stress of our life. Since 1950, Serie investigated about stress, and he offered his theory on stress theory. And many people, many medical people investigated after then about stress, what is the stress is. And the, some of the researchers received a Nobel Prize on this stress. But nowadays, because of stress, many people getting weak. I think the getting so-called the survival energy is weak. In this reason, many people had the disease, serious disease like cancer and so forth. Many serious disease is now occurring, but I don't want to terminate this situation to introduce the preference theory here. Could I? Oh, yes. Is it? Oh, yes. And today I would like to emphasize about the
tremendous number of the solicitors, both of the companies and money at the very beginning of the United States. Benjamin Franklin said that the money, that is, I must say, worst war in this world, the worst. And not time is money, but time is life. Then what is that life? Life is, we, I must say, three stages life. Life is not only one, but three stages, body, mind, and even spirit. And this is a tree, campus tree in my near house. I took this tree. And because of stress. They know about that. So never disturb, never close the branch. I would like to summarize our diary. Before conception, this is mother conception. And the, before the conception, I considering about the universe with affection. You are born here, all people. And between the conception, this is the real society. This is a birthday here. During the conception. It's very and as I said, body, mind, and spirit, we might destroy it, but the fourth stage of life, fourth stage. It's not the all gone, but the, you can meet again, this chair. The whole universe, that is the affection of the universe, I might say. There are many phenomena. You can consider deeply about affection of the universe if you will be alone. Yes, this is the how to develop your third stage of life. The first and second stage is just an environment for your third stage. And then, if you look always at your own personality, then your life will be this is the third stage of life, to be realized. With third stage of life, the spirit is living each other, and further, God for may not be overcome. It means we have the ability to see it like animals. Then the wall, struggle, and so on. Automatically, many people say, don't have any wall at all. They say, but how? That is the question. How can we approach to the healthy and peaceful society? That is the question. This is the, my name, the 3-year-old girl. And one day, I asked her, what do you want to play? She answered, immediately. I want to growing. Then you want to please cure not growing. And then what did she brought me this growing. This is my face. And this is my wife, the face. I'm very surprised. She encouraged us. That's the thing about the Lord. She knows not that he wants to die. Just born. She broke from her evil. Only such a time she does create his mind. Such a wonderful this the encourage, they encourage us for only. That is the wonderful God, strong only that we need.
This is a discussion about If we change the atmosphere, then the
area.
We know that is the question.
This is the human patient laboratory. That is produced by mother placenta. This is a week of placenta. After the 80 weeks, the big difference in big data in the very step. So we get the different inspired. So almost over 80% of mothers, her placenta is abnormal. So this is the problem. The noise problem is here. This is very difficult. Mother herself is adapted. But the toxin, if the mother has the baby, then the baby this is the data. I published the special video of this area in 1977. And this is the year 1960. There was no jet pet and then growth. But after the 64 years, then bigger growth. What happened? The late birth rate, the lower birth, so this is the birth rate, the male and female also the from the 1665 their birth rate is dramatically decreased. So that is the mother cannot take the survival button per baby in this case. That is the stress. Stress may deceive the among the also the brain. So therefore, the situation and the mind and the second stage I emphasize the survival energy. And if you have the doctor today, then this way and prepare it, then your body is very healthy.
Thank you, Professor Addo, for this interesting lecture and for your very wide view of our environment and our life. I would ask to the audience if there are questions or comments about this lecture. Professor Pompoli, please.
Later on 1950 as
separate different situations of our mind. On the right, we have a field that is not going to be light. That's at the beginning. Yes, okay, this one. So you choose 1950.
Yeah.
And before,
1950 is the progression of the because they don't know about stress, the word of stress. We did not know what stress means. After the investigation about the stress, lots of people going to the hospital because of the mind, psychiatric body.
Surely the life was very different now.
Yes,
I mean that in any case, before 1950, people have stress, maybe for other agents, maybe the poverty or the other aspect of the life, for anything that our thinking.
So after the stress, yeah, and people know about the what we are telling.
Can you show also the next one, the next picture? The next one? Okay. So you say we can talk about two kinds of life, the first stage and the second stage, and we share this life with animals, for example.
Yeah.
Okay. And we can talk about the third stage of life, the creative life. But do you think that these stages are different or they develop contemporary in the same parallel? I mean, the question is they are parallel.
Yeah, parallel. So I might say,
yes,
the opera house like this should have this stage. Frontal stage, rear stage, and upper stage.
One suggestion that I have from your talk is that we can consider very important in this way the fact that the man is the only animal who developed language. The language base is a structure just of time and space, and there is a correlation between time and space. So I think that the speech, the language, is a very important point which can be inserted in your idea, your frame. Because this is something that differs human from other animals. And speech is mainly related to space, and time. Our language, the verbs, the most of the items of the language are related to the time. We are here now, we are going tomorrow, we went yesterday, and so on. And where we are here, and yesterday we are there, and so on. Time and position and space are very much interrelated in the language. The language came from this interrelation of the man with the environment. So I think this is another point that supports your view of the first stage of the life, which is just the life of man.
There is another question by Professor Maffei. Please, Gino.
About correlation between the weight of child, and that tragic aircraft, which is very interesting. You know, if there have been other studies in the more recent years about this correlation. In his life, he stopped in 1970s. After there have been other research about this problem.
Topic stress.
For stress is connected to the traffic of traffic and connected to the fact that child was born with one of the last slides you presented.
So talking here the first time. So therefore about the purpose difference will be how much for our life. Yeah, I am expecting that a healthy life. But nowadays, we know the medical field, there are a lot of the hospitals, a lot of patients. All of the patients who somehow affected by it. That is very
good. Yeah. Right, thank you again. Okay. Thank you again, Professor Ando. And now we have to move to the first keynote of the symposium given by Professor Emeritus Alessandro Cocchi with the title From Felsina to Bologna, Historical Development and Temporal Design. Please, Professor Cocchi.
Sì, può andare. Io uso questa freccia qui. Se vediamo come parte. Lascia vedere la slide dopo.
No, 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 mi interessa. Mi interessa quella perché le leggo. Ok. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I will speak about historical development of Bologna. As we are in Bologna, and I think it would be interesting for everybody to see something of Bologna. Nature gives us an environment that is not always pleasant at our senses. Not only sun, green, flowers, some water, but also hot, cold, storm, and so on. So we must modify our environment to the best of our possibilities to reach satisfactory living conditions. About 2,000 years ago, Vitruvius said that this must be the job of an architect, adding that its work must be the child of practice and theory. During time elapsed, the scientific knowledge has grown up to actual level, giving a scientific basis to the theory of the time. Computers opened a new way to a deepest investigation of our mind. The work that Professor Ando was carrying on in the field of audio perception and sound preference was already a relevant contribution to the work of architects, but I found it very interesting when 17 years ago in Rimini he exposed me his idea to extend the concepts of individual preference to all human senses in favor of a better based architectural design. From that time to now, we met at subsequent editions of ASTD or elsewhere to discuss the evolution of its activity in this framework. I addressed my personal contribution in this field to explore the compatibility of his theory with the European projecting way. This lecture is aimed to be a further step based on a short review of the historical development of Bologna Town. Human settlement in the land we are dealing with began when Villanovians, at the age of bronze discovery, abandoned the lower slopes of the Apennines and began to build their straw dwellings in the west side of the actual town. In the meanwhile, a similar process happened also in the east side, as testified from findings of Villanovian culture. We can imagine the Sealist settlements like the actual one shown in this picture. Some years ago, a hut similar to a Villanovian one was built and is now visible in the main Bologna garden, where an Etruscan cemetery and a big sarcophagus in travertine stone were also found. Between those primary lowlander settlements, some water streams were flowing. People moved toward them and began to organize activities, taking advantage from this source of energy that, at the same time, became a useful way to reach other villages and the sea. Dark lines in the map show water channels still existing under the modern town that attracted people from both sides. So rose the former Etruscan settlement of Felsina, here superposed in red to a modern map. Till to the 6th century BC, Felsina grew as a working and cultural center, becoming also Etruria capital in Po River Valley. The Reno River became a relevant trading way, as testified from findings of sailboats along the river and near the sea, for instance, Pina, an harbor frequented also by Greek sailors. During the 4th century BC, Galliboi began to populate the town, whose name changed in the Celtic Bona. In 189 BC, the Latin colony established here from Romans took the name Bononia. Romans settled down the typical network of perpendicular roads that still characterizes the middle of the town. The Via Emilia connected the sea to the northwest of Europe and, crossing the town from east to west, acted also as the Cumanus Maximum. In 53 AD, the Emperor Nero supported the reconstruction of the east side of the city, destroyed by a furious fire. In his honor, the first theater stone made in the empire was erected in Bologna, and the big statue still remains in city's archaeological museum. Quite completely destroyed during the Middle Age in the development of the town, its shape is still visible. There are some remains, and this is the location of the theater. Due to the crisis of the Roman Empire, in the 3rd-5th AD, a defensive wall was erected in Selenite, a local stone. The Lombard addition, fan-shaped, opened the ways toward Ravenna, Rimini, and Florence. After some alternate war events, the Selenite wall, still visible in the basement of the Imperial Palace, was completely destroyed, and the town was almost abandoned. In 1011 AD, a period of economic growth started. Citizens' enterprising spirit favored the formation of tailors, goldsmiths, shoemakers, butchers, corporations. These activities ensured fundamentals in the future economic development of the town. Very relevant for the future university birth was the presence of a renowned lawyer, for instance, Irnerio. The growth of the town accounted for an enlargement, so a new wall was erected at the end of 11 AD, including the former Roman town and the Selenite wall. These are the Torresotti, an example of the Torresotti till remaining. In this period, one of the relevant architectural aspects of the town were the towers that important families built to defend their power, assessed by their aid. Obviously, this is a model. In this period was built the most famous tower, the Asinelli, from the name of a rich family. Due to its height, originally 60, then 100 meters, it became soon after the symbol of the public governance. Someone misunderstand Garisenda with Asinelli, but the inclined one is Garisenda, not Asinelli. At the beginning of the 12 AD, the representative of the emperor died, and citizens took the opportunity for a rebellion. The middle of the town was destroyed again, and the new governance, said Comune, with certain political independence, was established, as in many other Italian towns. Between the end of 12 and 14 AD, a new enlargement of the town asked for more land and a new defensive wall, of which are still visible some stretches and all the doors. A unique character of the urban building style of that time, still widely in use for modern edification, is private, covered spaces for public utilization, the portici. Space problems are the starting point of this local peculiarity. To increase inside flats dimensions, people began to extend them upon the road, the upper facades coming more and more closest. So, at the end of 13 AD, the municipality decided to compel every new building maker to realize in front of the road a public covered space whose height ought to be at least that of a riding man. The most famous portico was built as a shelter for people going in processions with the portrait of Lord's mother between its shrine and the town. This portico is long more 3 kilometers. Actually, the urban network of portici is about 33 kilometers long. Through the following centuries, Bologna gradually expanded. The richest citizens became owners of a bit of land short in front of the internal network of roads, but extended in depth. So the new mansions were built with little internal courtyards and gardens. If the space available was very limited, their walls were painted so to look larger. Through the main entrance of many mansions, it is still possible to see those wall penthouses, usually called trompe-l'œil. Major changes in the town architectural organization occurred after the unity of Italy, after the First World War. Many old little buildings, ovals and patricial towers, were destroyed to give space to main streets and squares. patricial towers and small buildings at the beginning of 20 AD, now no more visible, they are destroyed. The completion of Comunale frontal view was made at the beginning of 30. As we have seen, Fersina economy and building practice started around some channels crossing the site. Once there were also an harbor and the shipable channels, as we can see from these images. Many industrial activities flowed with the energy of water. Now they are quite all covered, even for sanitary reasons, giving space to the rise of vehicular traffic that now heavily interfere with our life. Preference can be tested directly following Professor Ando's leading ideas, but it seems hard to think of individual tests when people concerned are too much, as for instance in a town quarter. Looking at Bologna development, we have seen that there are many points of forced preference in the architecture of a town. The availability of a new harder metal for weapons allowed people to abandon hills and occupy the more fruitful valley. The call from water flows made easy to collect in a community to work together. The opportunity of a common civil organization brought to a planned land distribution. Walls of different size were erected to defend citizens from invaders, while towers were utilized also for internal strugglers. To get more space between houses and protect public space with private charge, a big system of portici was created along the streets. During the last two centuries, the net of channels was overlapped and main streets enlarged. However, we can recognize that even the achievements are in the way of thinking of Ando's three stages of life. This can be made at two different levels. In the line of temporal design, in 25 in Kokubu, I proposed an urban organization with three concentric areas. The central one, Quiet, to be utilized for cultural activities and entertainments, where ancient people, already retired from work, can live their third stage of life free from noise. The intermediate one, nighttime quiet, where people come into the world, grow in body and mind, and spend a certain lot of time chiefly in intellectual work in schools and universities. First and second stage of life. The external one will instead be devoted to essential activities, transport, industrial works, as well as amusing and noisy activities, the most active part of the second stage of life. This is what is happening in most towns in Italy, and not only. We can recognize this trend also in Bologna, where the land within the ancient doors ring will be, slowly, but unavoidably for economical and practical reasons, abandoned from young active people. In its interior, unfortunately, still remains a big amount of traffic which pollute air with noise and small particles. There is another relevant aspect at planetary level that we cannot forget. The historical analysis of the development of Bologna puts in evidence that the first 2,000 years were characterized by continuous fickleness, as the first stage of life of many humans is. During the following 500 years, we found the flourish of industrial activities based on primary resources of energy, water flow, coal, then oil and gas combustion. The Second World War caused destruction and death, but it was not so for scientific development. Nuclear energy and computers are sons of that terrible period. With the post-Second World War, work on reconstruction, do we have concluded the second stage of life of our planet? We hope not. But now, Occidental humanity is aging, while our environment is troubled from pollution, waste of water, and primary energy resources. Going on in such a way, really like a human in the third stage of life, our planet will perish. To avoid this, it is necessary to develop now a new kind of temporal design at an extensive scale, able to drive humanity towards more sustainable choices. Thanks for your kind attention.
Thank you to Professor Kocchi for this also very wide view, and this maybe not known by everybody historical perspective on Bologna. And of course, I would like to ask to the audience if there are questions or comments.
Please.
Gino, please.
One of the strengths of the cities is an Sofia, with the capacity to have in the same place different sensations. So other views say that in a city you should cross the street to find a place where you find quiet. And cross the other street and find a place where you have a vibrancy, so more. So I think there could be some problems in thinking the city in which people live in one side, people on the other side. You can build some barriers.
Yes.
Which
yes.
is not a strength. But this is a...
I understand it so, but anyway, in Kukubu there was a community that was founding, five communities in one. So they asked what they can do. And they said preferably put theaters in the middle for the first stage. So, thank you.
Thank you again, Professor Kocchi. Any other question? If not, now we have...
No.
Oh, yes, sorry. Please.
Thank you for your talk. I gave your talk, you ended on the negative note, but gave us a glimmer of hope by saying that well, if the temple would like to help us to improve our environment, perhaps give us some examples or suggestions as to what kind of temple we designed in mind in order to improve the world.
I beg your pardon, but you speak in speed for me.
No, sure. At the end of the talk, you gave a negative view of our future, that the world will perish for and pollution of energy. And temporal design may be a way to improve our world, but you didn't give any examples.
Oh, I have nothing in mind. Excuse me, but it was the opportunity to link in some way the theory of temporal and spatial design that is limited to an audience, for instance, and the poor people of a town. They are not called to say their preference, but it is some politics that decide, for instance, to destroy the walls and so on. Thank you.
Yes, please, Professor Zhang.
I understand what we are saying.
And the another one is how those high end typical business patterns like corridors are affecting the acoustics of the
world. Oh no, I don't know acoustic in the town. It was. Yes, but the also portici are much responsible for acoustical and pollution in the town, within the town. When we measured the noise in the town, we found a big correlation from the presence of portico and an higher level of noise. They are rezoning, obviously.
If I can add that the height of the tower was not a problem, but the plan for a new church, this was a very big problem. In fact, if you look at the most famous church in Bologna, San Petronio, you see that actually it is only part of the original planned church, which was designed to be even greater than St. Petrus in Rome. So it was going to be the largest church in the world, and this was not allowed by the Catholic governance in Rome. So this building was stopped, and now we have only one of the branches of the originally planned church. So they were mainly thinking on religious buildings. Towers, which were private buildings, were not of concern, but they were very attentive to the churches. It was stopped in a very abrupt way, just saying no, don't, and stop. So thank you again, Professor Cocchi. And now we can profit from the coffee break. Works will begin again at 10:50.